Nasal Fractures by Dr. Carlo Ojeda, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. It's important that you get medical help right away if you have a nasal fracture and the bleeding will not stop. If you have clear fluid draining from your nose, if you suspect a blood clot is in the septum, which we'll talk about in a little bit, if you suspect a neck or head injury because the patient has nausea, vomiting, persistent headache, or other significant neurological findings, if the nose looks significantly deformed, if the person is having difficulty breathing. If you have any of these, just go straight to the emergency department or call your primary care provider. The nasal bones are the most commonly fractured bony structures of the maxillofacial complex. As you can see in this picture, this nose was significantly deformed at the time of injury. After fixation, usually by the ENT specialist after the initial emergency room visit, that was the final outcome on the right picture. Medical issues and complications. High-force mid-facial injuries may involve structures other than the nose itself. You can have a septal hematoma. This is a common and serious complication of nasal trauma. Septal hematomas are collections of blood in the subperichondral space. This places pressure on the underlying cartilage, resulting in irreversible necrosis of the septum. The patient may also become predisposed to infection, and a saddle deformity may develop from loss of tissue. This can even develop into a perforated septum. Drainage procedure. Septal hematomas must be drained immediately after finding them. Cotton pledges soaked with 4% cocaine are used as topical anesthesia. A scalpel incision must be made to allow drainage. A small Penrose-type drain is placed to prevent reaccumulation of the blood. Finally, nasal packing is placed. The patient should be started on oral antibiotics with anti-staphylococcal coverage to prevent superinfection. Another complication of nasal fractures, or facial trauma for that matter, is blowout fractures. The orbital wall and orbital floor blowout fractures may occur. As you can see in this picture, both of these patients are trying to look up with both eyes. Only one of the eyes looks up, the other one stays in the middle. This is the result of entrapment. Because of swelling and deformity of the orbital rim, the muscles and nerve get stuck and the patient is unable to look up fully without getting double vision. Any abnormality of ocular anatomy or function should alert the clinician of the possibility of a blowout fracture. A common finding is extraocular muscle dysfunction, commonly characterized by inability to look up on the affected side. The presenting complaint may be diplopia or double vision. Nasolacrimal duct injury is another complication in which the nasolacrimal duct gets disrupted and you are unable to secrete your drops, teardrops normally. Infection. Although rare, infections result from nasal fractures can cause serious complications. For these reasons, patients should be placed on antibiotics with coverage for staphylococcal pathogens. Fracture of the cribriform plate. This type of injury may predispose to leakage of CSF, allowing rare but extremely serious complications such as meningitis, encephalitis, or even brain abscess to follow. Drainage of clear rhinorrhea immediately after trauma to the midface and up to several days later should alert the physician of this possibility. This is a picture of an undisplaced nasal fracture. You can see the fracture lines on the nasal bone. Also, you can notice in this picture that most of the nose is not composed of bone or cartilage, but the cartilage themselves can be torn. High-force nasal trauma resulting in deformity from displaced fractures or dislocations or from comminuted fractures may require open reduction and/or fixation by a surgeon. Consultations. If specialists were not consulted during the initial patient visit, appropriate referral to an ENT doctor, maxillofacial surgeon, or even a plastic surgeon for outpatient management is often warranted. Other treatment. In the acute phase, the patient should apply ice to the nose and elevate the head in aid of reducing any swelling present. Nasal decongestants are prescribed to help reduce swelling and mucosal congestion. Medications. The doctor may prescribe antibiotics, decongestants, analgesics, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like NSAIDs, and anesthetics. In healthy adults, fracture healing occurs in approximately 3 weeks. Sometimes a splint may be put in after fixation to avoid any recurrence of swelling or deformity. Please call your doctor if you have any of the issues we mentioned initially. The bleeding won't stop, there's clear fluid from your nose, you suspect there's a blood clot in the nasal septum, you have signs of a head injury like nausea, vomiting, any neurological symptoms, or if you're experiencing trouble breathing. For more videos like this, please visit edexitvideo.com. These videos are for education purposes only, and you should always follow the advice of your own physician.